Christmas, Seattle. Yes, this is Dr. Frasier Crane coming to you on Christmas Day. Christmas, that very magical time of the year when each moment is as unique as a snowflake, never to be recreated.
I'm sorry, Frasier. The news went over. You're going to have to do that again.
Merry Christmas, Seattle.
Well, as we head into our second hour, I'd like to lighten things up a bit. Although, Ned, we were certainly glad to hear from you and how you got mugged on your way home from the soup kitchen. Roz, who's next?
We have Don on line 5. He wants to tell us about a time when he was filled with the Christmas spirit.
It's about time. Hello, Don.
Hello, Dr. Crane. Something happened to me yesterday that kind of sums up why we call this a season of giving.
Well, then swaddle me in Christmas cheer.
Okay, well, you see, I was driving home from the gym, and I suddenly realized I had left my favorite old pair of sneakers on the roof of the car. So I look back, and there's this homeless guy, and he'd already picked them up, and he's putting them on. So I just thought, what the hell? And I kept driving.
So your experience of the Christmas spirit would be that you didn't slam the car into reverse, speed back there, and rip a pair of smelly old sneakers out of a homeless man's hands. Well, Ross, this is special. I think we got Santa Claus himself on the line.
I'm sorry. That was the last time. I'm okay now. I'm really okay.
No, I'm not.
Barry, listen, I've got to put you on hold for a bit while you pull yourself together, but please, please stay on the line. I'd really like to help you.
It's all right. I think I got a hold of myself.
So you see, Dr. Crane, I've fallen in the shower so many times. They can't fit any more pins in my hips.
Gladys, listen, can I put you on hold for a second? There's somebody else I have to check on. How's it going there, Barry? My sentiments exactly.